Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. When a story comes out that announces President Trump might not be a homosexual, but then labels him as a homo something else, then you know you're either reading a satirical piece from the Babylon Bee, or it might be written by a soy-drinking, weak-skinned liberal. This story turned out to be HuffPost's editor-at-large, Michelangelo Signorile, who casually talked about Trump and his lust for hanging with the guys over spending time with, or mentioning his connections to, the women in his life or the female leaders. Signorile talked about Trump and goes into homosocial aspect, but the whole thing is laughable at best. Laughing at the article, not with it. There's a huge difference. Trump may not be a homosexual, but writing an article announcing it and then turning it into a personal rant about a guy being homosocial serves what purpose? Was it a slow news day? I think not. On a day where Roseanne bats a home run with her explanation of the Valerie Jarrett tweet and Whoopi Goldberg clashing heads with Jeanine Pirro, then there's certainly a handful of stories to keep things moving. Top that off with Maxine Waters supporters burning flags near her office, and there are at least three stories that would easily top this. It seems like Mr. Editor-at-Large wanted to toot his own horn, but I'm pretty sure I know what end that horn is sticking out of. He writes well, but his points are pointless. Let's dissect his little ranty piece about Trump hanging with the fellas. His parts are in bold and mine are just under it, in plain text, where anything he says is easily picked to pieces with a little more logic, common sense, and much less beta boy soy. Trending, Dems declare war on Michelle Obama after finding, red flag, she was hiding all along since the 2016 election and even before. There has been a persistent meme, sometimes in the form of protest art or jokes by comedians, posing President Donald Trump and Russian President Vladimir Putin as gay lovers. As HuffPost's James Michael Nichols noted in criticizing a New York Times animated comic earlier this week, these depictions often depend solely on homophobia to get a laugh. There is no larger message, no big picture takeaway. Nichols wrote, just the supposed humor embedded within the idea that tenderness between two men is in some way mockable. He's absolutely right. There are gay memes about Barack Obama, the Bushes, and it's just one of those things that always seem to appear on the internet via social media, message boards, and emails. People make gay memes out of anyone and everyone. Making them about Trump and Putin only happened because of all the people who said there was collusion with Russia. Had someone said there was collusion with the Queen of England, then there would be memes made of Trump and her. In fact, there already are. Anyone who Trump comes in contact with is fair game to end up on a meme. That's the way the internet works. As soon as there's the slightest bit of conspiracy, then someone will make a meme of it. If it's a funny gay meme, then that's just what happens. Some memes are offensive, some are hilarious, and again, that's just how it goes. They don't have any other meaning other than to make people laugh or sometimes get a point across. Mostly, they're just for laughs. Memes aren't exactly Encyclopedia Britannica, so let's not act like they're full of information and start writing a thesis over them. There is, however, something going on with Trump and his affection for certain types of men. Well-meaning liberals either aren't able to discern that it's not a gay thing, or they're not interested in aiming higher than the laziest, most offensive joke available. Trump isn't homosexual or bisexual, at least, not based on any information we have. He likes having s**x with women and has bragged about his sexual conquests in his books. A Playboy playmate has alleged an affair with him, as has a female porn star. And then there are his three wives, and, according to Trump, lots of other women before. There haven't been any rumors of s**x with men. But there have been allegations of leering at teenage girls at beauty pageants, and, of course, sexual harassment and assault against women, which he's bragged about on tape and brushed off when asked about it. Lots of people have multiple wives. Not every relationship works out. Alleged affairs don't count until they're proven. If by teenage girls, you mean 18 and 19-year-olds, then what American male isn't checking out the ladies in a beauty pageant? If the college-aged girls prance around in a bikini on stage, then tell me what male in the audience isn't looking. They all are. Even the gay men will look because they'll criticize the outfits with the women. It's not much different than going to a public beach where college girls are wearing a bikini. When people bring up Trump's recorded tape about grabbing women by the PSS, why then that's laughable as well. That's locker room talk, and only people looking for a reason to be angry would ever complain about it. Most people with a logical way of thinking would realize that's just a generic way that some men talk. Women talk like that too when they're among their peers, so let's stop acting like Trump saying a comment about ladies to other men is a big deal. It's not. Trump is, however, staunchly homosocial. That is, he appears to almost exclusively prefer men for intimate, meaningful, non-sexual relationships, while he thinks of women as pretty much just for *x, as decorative accessories, or in traditional roles that do not put them on equal footing. How do you know what Trump thinks about women? A woman as smart as Melania Trump had money before she met him, didn't need to mother a child with him, and had no idea she would end up as the first lady. She could have done well without Donald, but there must have been something that kept her with him. Just because Trump doesn't announce his entire intimate life on Twitter or Facebook like some people do, that doesn't mean he doesn't have a very good and intimate relationship with her. Trump shows a consistent pattern of viewing women as far beneath him, which makes him incapable of the kind of relationship in which he and a woman are intellectual equals. Whenever a woman rises to challenge him as an equal, he appears threatened and tries to slap her down, from Hillary Clinton, who Trump said doesn't have stamina or a presidential look, and Senator Elizabeth Warren, whom he demeans with a racial slur, to Representative Maxine Waters, whom he's attacked as a low IQ person, and, pathetically, grieving Gold Star mothers who've had the courage to criticize him. That's nothing more than your skewed view on it because you seem to dislike Trump. Other people see Trump holding many women in high regards. What Trump said about Hillary, Warren, and Waters all seem to be relatively true. Does Hillary really have the stamina to keep up with a fast-paced Trump? That's doubtful. When she's not having coughing fits, then she's falling down steps in other countries. Is it really a racial slur to call Warren Pocahontas and ask her to prove her ancestry with a DNA test? No, that's calling her out for possibly telling lies, and each time she crawls into a cave and denies to prove herself. Maxine Waters is another story altogether. The poverty pimp lives in what most people might consider a mansion outside of her pathetically disgusting 43rd congressional district. How many achievements does she have over the course of her career? Her biggest accomplishment is running her base-sized mouth. She offers nothing for the people in her district who sleep on the streets in feces. Sociologists and psychologists have long discussed homosociality as distinct from homosexuality. One can be homosexual, for example, but heterosocial or bisocial, having intimate, non-sexual relationships only with the opposite gender or people of both genders, respectively. And there are definitely homosexuals who are mostly homosocial, only hanging out with other gay, or even straight, dudes, period. The world of gay men has its share of misogyny, too. What is the point other than grabbing information from Wikipedia to sound smart? While sexual orientation today is considered an innate characteristic by most medical professionals and social scientists, social preference is learned within culture. It's literally about how people are socialized. Feminists have written about homosociality in societies, how it privileges men in the workplace and in familial and social settings where men and women have often been segregated. There are entire societies that are homosocial to the extreme, such as Saudi Arabia, and they are societies in which women are often brutally oppressed. So basically, Islam. Aren't they oppressive to women and gays? I don't see many feminists fighting those guys, do you? Trump often seems to connect more with the leaders of those countries. He was wowed by the Saudi royal treatment, bonding with King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud on his first foreign trip, than by those of Western countries where women are heads of state. He recently humiliated UK Prime Minister Theresa May, trashing her in an interview, then falsely calling it fake news when asked about it in front of her. And he has repeatedly dismissed, mistreated and attacked German Chancellor Angela Merkel in ways that seem more personal than political. Trump also trashed Kim Jong-un, who is male. Trump doesn't have to like everyone, and it's acceptable for him to voice his opinion on people he doesn't like. If he wants to throw Merkel under the bus, then go ahead. Her own people do it as well, since she's ruined Germany with her lust for migrants, and there are asterisky parties. London looks terrible right now as well. A once romantic city where people travel to get iconic pictures and even get engaged looks more like a third world SH thall, kinda like Maxine Waters' district in California. Why should Trump be forced to praise or get along with everyone when it's obvious some people are doing a terrible job? The term homosocial has been around for a longer time, but the influential scholar Eve Kosofsky Sedgwick popularized its use in the 80s, writing on male homosocial desire, and specifically about how anxiety around masculinity and around homosexuality influence it. A 2007 Australian study documented the homosocial organisation of men's heterosexual relations, noting that among some men, male-male friendships take priority over male-female relations, and platonic friendships with women are dangerously feminizing. Sexual activity is a key path to masculine status, and other men are the audience, always imagined and sometimes real, for one's sexual activities. Heterosexual *X itself can be the medium through which male bonding is enacted. Last men's sexual storytelling is shaped by homosocial masculine cultures. Sound like a certain misogynist-in-chief. The last two lines are a perfect description of the infamous Access Hollywood tape. At this point, it seems like HuffPost's editor-at-large, Michelangelo Signorile, might be a beta male feminist. There's a different bond between male friends and male-female friendships. It's different and always will be. There's nothing wrong with that. Men do different things with other guys than they often do with women. It's the same thing for women as well. There is literally no point to the entire article that Signorile wrote other than to hear himself talk or get some likes on social media. Men used to tell of their sexual conquests all the time. Women do it too. Ever watch an episode of just about any show that women like? It goes both ways, and there's nothing wrong with men or women telling of their sexual conquests if that's what they feel like talking about. It's articles like this published on sites like HuffPost that really just make nothing into something. Then people read it and realize it's nothing. What a waste of time that was, right? Thanks for nothing, Michelangelo Signorile. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.